in my hand, which sits on the wall in the foyer. And if you look at this picture close enough, it looks like the guy that's sitting behind me, or the awesome man of God who's sitting behind me. However, this is really a blessing to us, because this is a generation moving down. Now, as Dad raised this son, he's following in Dad's footsteps. However, he's filling his own footsteps. This was a former pastor here at First Baptist. Now, he's going to come in his own way. But he sent a bio, but the bio is really not that important to me. His credentials really come from the Holy Ghost. So as you sit in your tent doors today and everything adjusted in and after, we can get prepared here, I'm going to let him introduce himself. And amen. Everybody that came, that's family, either and or friend of the Reverend Barry Williams, or those who traveled with him from Pennsylvania, would you please stand? I want to say to you, we thank you for joining us on today. And I'm going to tell you, we're going to try to make your day an awesome and blessed day. Let's give them a hand. Amen. So I'm going to present to some and introduce to others. And the reason we're omitting the song, we're going to go ahead and get into the piece of the word. It's a little after 12. I don't want y'all to get... It's hard for you to get bored in your seat if you know the Holy Ghost. But you know how some folks are. They sit too long, they get fidgety. So that's before you get to nod and your head shaking. We're going to stand up and give him a grand hand clap of praise and some love as he prays for... prepared his heart for the word of God. Again, the son of an awesome man of God who introduced his own self. I present the son and introduce to the Reverend Pastor Williams from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania.
Yes.
Give him a hand.
Come on and give God some praise.
Hallelujah!
Give him praise. First, give an honor to God, who's the head of my life. In him I live, move, and have my being.
Yes.
To the angel of this church, the Reverend Dr. C. E. Williams. Come on, let's celebrate this man of God. Ministers and deacons that are on the roster, members, friends, family of this great church, to God be the glory.
Thank you.
It is such a great honor and pleasure to be here in the house of the Lord just one more time.
Amen. Amen.
To be able to stand behind this sacred desk that my father once stood behind. Without further ado, there is a word from the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
There is a word from the Lord. You may be seated. Without Christ, I could do nothing. Without Christ,
take your time.
I fell without Jesus. My life Let me sing it again. Without Christ, I could do nothing. Without Christ, will be coming from 2 Chronicles chapter 20. The 15th verse. If you haven't, say amen.
Amen.
You need just a little more time. Say, hold up, hold up. Amen. And the word of the Lord, it reads, the Bible says, and the Lord, he said, hearken ye all, Judah, and ye inhabitants of Jerusalem, and thou King Jehoshaphat, thus saith the Lord unto you, be not afraid, nor dismayed by reason of this great multitude, for the battle is not yours but God's. Verse 16 says, tomorrow, somebody say tomorrow, go ye down against them, behold, they come up by the cliffs of this, and ye shall find them at the end of the brook before the wilderness of Jeroboam. Verse 17 says, ye shall not need to fight in this battle. Set yourselves, stand ye still, and see the salvation of the Lord. O Judah and Jerusalem, fear not, nor be dismayed. Tomorrow, somebody say tomorrow. Go out against them, for the Lord will be with you. Verse number 18, it says, and Jehoshaphat bowed his head with his face to the ground, and all Judah and the inhabitants of Jerusalem fell before the Lord, worshiping the Lord. And verse 20 says, and they rose early in the morning, and they went forth into the wilderness of Tekoa. And then I want to go down to the 21st verse, and it says, and when he had consulted with the people, he appointed singers unto the Lord, and that they should praise the beauty of holiness as they went out before the army, and to say, praise the Lord, for his mercy endureth forever. And when they began to sing and to praise, the Lord set an ambushment against the children of Ammon and Moab and Mount Syria, which were come up against Judah, and they were smitten. Amen. That's the reading of God's word. Eternal and all-wise God, Lord, I thank you for yet another chance to be able to stand before your people and to proclaim your gospel. God, I ask that you will open up their ears, open up their minds, open up their heart, that they may receive your word. Father God, that healing may take place, restoration, deliverance, set free, Father God, for you said in your word, wherever the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty.
Yes,
God, we thank you right now for this moment.
Yes.
God, it is for your glory, God, that we magnify you, for you said if you be lifted up, you will draw all men unto thee. And God, we know that you're able to do it, for you said in your word, for whatsoever I ask, it shall be done in the name of Jesus. And God, I believe it right now that somebody here may cry out, Lord, Lord, what must I do to be saved? In the mighty name of Jesus that I pray, amen. Amen. Just want to speak to you briefly on this subject. The battle is not yours, it's the Lord's. It's the Lord. This title, which is also in the text, suggests that there will be some battles in our life. It does not necessarily mean that we will have to fight these battles with our hands, but there will be some battles in our life that will challenge our faith.
Yes.
Matter of fact, there are many of us in here today that is in a battle right now. Seems like there's always something that we have to fight for. Fighting just to make ends meet. Fighting because the children are out of control. Fighting because relationships are on the verge of collapse. Fighting because the integrity of our names have been compromised. But there are also some internal fights. You have to fight some insecurities. You have to fight some doubts. You have to fight some childhood issues that found its way into our adulthood. But brothers and sisters, this story should be an encouragement to our faith to know that no matter how much we would like to handle the fight on our own, there are just some battles that only God can and He will work out. Most of us, when we deal with the issues of our lives, we want to handle it on our own because we are in control. Because the issue of control has a lot to do with the issue of fear. Whenever you are in control, you're not as fearful. In other words, you don't mind speeding down the street as long as you are driving. Amen? Because most of us are comfortable when we have some level of control. But just keep on living, because every now and then, things will get out of control. As Christians, whenever we are faced with a battle, we have to learn to give God total control and replace any fear with faith. So here in the text, King Jehoshaphat was faced with a situation that was beyond his control. In verse number 12, Jehoshaphat said, "For we have no might against this great company that cometh against us, neither do we know what to do." That is called fear. But then he says, "Our eyes are upon the Lord." Brothers and sisters, that's faith. So Jehoshaphat, in other words, he was trapped between fear and faith. So the first thing that God says is, fear not, nor be dismayed by this great multitude. In other words, if you have enough faith, it doesn't matter how big the problem is. We serve a big God that will cover you in the midst of whatever you're going through. Let me see if I can make it plain. I remember coming across an article about something that happened this time last year. It was about 147 African college students in Africa who was massacred by Islamic terrorists. And as the journalists and the media began to come onto the scene, there was this one particular young lady that they was interested in because she was covered in blood. And as they went over to interview her and talk to her, they said, well, how did you survive? What did you do to survive? They said, well, did you hide? Did you go run away? She said, I know what you mean because my friend got killed in that massacre. She said, what happened was, she said, when the terrorists came into the room, I ran and I hid. And she said, when they left the room, I went over to my friend and I took her blood and I began to cover me from my head down to my toes. She said, I did that just in case they was to come back into the room. They would think that I was already dead. And she said, sure enough, they came back into the room and they walked right over me. She said, the only reason why I stand here as a survivor is because my friend's blood covered me. And brothers and sisters, I come to tell somebody in here today that the only reason why we stand here 2016 as survivors is because we have a friend named Jesus, and it was his blood that covered you in the midst of what you were going through. Man, I think the only reason why you are where you are today is because you've been through some things. And the only reason why you've been through some things was so that God can show you that he had his hands on you the whole entire time. Somebody look at their neighbor and say, neighbor, he got you covered.
Jesus, thank you.
That's peace. As we study the text, after God says that, after he says, fear not, he gives specific instructions. The Bible says that he said, set yourselves,
stand still,
and see the salvation of God. Let me say it again. The Bible said, set yourselves, stand still, and see the salvation of God. Brothers and sisters, set yourself simply means to get into position. The problem with some of us Christians is that we are out of position. Why? Because getting into position may mean changing some things on the inside. It may mean making some hard decisions. Getting into position may mean letting some things go. Even may mean letting some people go. Making some changes in my community. Doing something different for my family. But for those of us who are in position, that's why folk don't understand why you praise God the way you praise God. Because you've been there and you've done that. They don't understand why you don't go to places that you used to go anymore. Because you've been there, done that. And that's why here in the text, the Bible encourages us to stand still. And I come to tell somebody that standing still is not easy. You will have to stand still while you're hurting. You will have to stand still while people talk about you. You will have to stand still while somebody got a promotion that you was qualified for. But when you look back over your life, it was not in the good times, but it was in the bad times that God strengthened you. As we look back at the text, sit down, I'm just talking. As we look back at the text,
go ahead and preach.
We find something amazing. Jehoshaphat and all of Judah and all of Jerusalem begin worshiping and praising God. Now, Pastor, I had to think about this for a moment. I had to think about this for a moment because God said tomorrow. I had to sit down in my seat. I had to think about it because God said tomorrow. But they was worshiping and praising God today.
In other words, he said tomorrow, but they was praising God and before he even did anything yet. God has delivered you from many of things, and you can't even open your mouth and say, Lord, I thank you. But do you have enough faith to praise God for what he's about to do tomorrow in spite of what it looks like today? The Bible says that weeping may endure for a night, but joy shall come in the morning. I remember my high school days. There was this particular subject that I was failing. I'm not ashamed. I was failing this subject. And I remember the teacher saying, she said, if you come back tomorrow early in the morning at 7:30, now school started at 8. She said, I'm going to give a test. And I can remember the next morning, I'm getting up and I was mad. Make me get up early in the morning. I was upset. She could have did this yesterday. So I'm walking to school and I got into the classroom and I sat down and as we was waiting a little while, she began to pass out this clipboard. She said, everybody sign your name. And as we sat there and I signed my name and we was waiting for more people to come on in, she just said, class dismissed. Wait a minute. I got up early in the morning. And I didn't take the test. She said, well, because of you showed up.
Come on.
She said, because you showed up, you automatically got 100. And I come to tell somebody that God has been waiting for so many of us to get to the point of faith that you just show up. God has been waiting for you to show up to bless you. God has been waiting for you to show up to change your life. God has been waiting for you to show up to do something new. For some of us, God has been waiting for you to grow up, to show up. And if there's anybody in here know that if God, he will make a way for you. All he's waiting for you to do is show up. The Bible says they rose and they showed up early in the morning. See, the brothers and sisters, the problem is the devil, he wants you to stay right where you are. He wants you to stay right in the condition that you're in. He wants you to stay in the same state that you're in. But somebody look at your neighbor, show up. Time to show up. You got to show up. Yeah. They showed up.
But not only did they show up,
With praise. The Bible said, Jehoshaphat, he appointed singers, and they sung praise unto God. And as they came face to face with the enemy, as they sung, the enemy began to kill
each other.
In other words,
your praise will confuse the enemy.
Yes.
See, the
best way that the enemy can tear you down is to take away your praise. Make you think that you're not worthy. Make you think that you don't have what it takes. Make you think that you fail. Matter of fact, they will even condemn you for your sins and forget that they was practicing their own sins. But the Bible said, David said, I will bless the Lord at all times, and his praise shall continuously be in my mouth. And I don't stop by to forgive all, but I stop by to tell somebody that the battle is not yours, but it is yours. Mountains out of your life. Do you believe that God is able to live?
it's the Lord. You got to turn it over to God. You cannot handle everything. Sometimes the best way God can develop us is to train us in trouble. And that's why you've been going through what you've been going through. That's why the devil has been hitting you so hard. But the devil don't understand that God has a blessing for you in storage, and he's waiting to pour it out over your life. Let the devil do what the devil do. Let the people talk about you. Let the people pull you down. Let the people come up against you. But don't you throw in the towel. Don't you give up. Don't you give in. Because there's a blessing waiting for you on the other side. Watch this. The Bible said that after they killed each other, that they went over and they began to pick up of all of their possessions. And it took them 3 days just to get their blessing. And I come to tell somebody that whatever the devil has tried to steal from you, whatever joy that the devil has tried to take from you, whatever the devil has tried to steal, it's time to replace. God has a replacement for whatever you're going through. And I don't know who I come to talk to, but the battle is not yours. It's the Lord's. The road make it rough, and the hills make it hard to climb. But he will make a way for you. He will. Whatever he says, he will do it. Whatever he says, it will come to pass. Do I got a witness in here? I'm on my way to my feet. But you got to praise God in the midst of what you're going through. Give God praise in spite of what it looks like. Give God praise. The battle is not yours. It's the Lord. Pastor, keep on showing up in spite of who don't like you. Choir, keep on singing the word of God. Is there anybody in here? The battle is not yours. We have somebody here. This joy that I have, the world is given to you. And the world can't take it away. Is there anybody, that the battle is not yours? He said, I'll walk with you. I'll talk with you. But I'll never leave you. Nor will I forsake you. Wipe the tears from your eyes. Stand up straight. Lift your head up high. The battle is not yours. It's the Lord's. Somebody say tomorrow. There's a miracle waiting. Tomorrow, there's a blessing waiting. Tomorrow, is there anybody in here that can praise him today for what he's about to do in your life? The battle.
Yes.
It's not yours. It's the Lord's. Come on, you just gotta show up. You gotta show up. And when you stand, you got to show up. And when you show up, you got to stand.
Yes.
Sometimes we don't like going through tests. But sometimes you just got to show up and let God work it out. How many believe that God can work it out? How many believe that God has already worked it out? All you got to do is look back over your life. You could have been dead and gone a long time ago. You could have been dead and gone a long time ago. What should have happened to you? God did not allow it. Hallelujah. 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 This battle is not yours. It's the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. And amen. God